Today, I'd like to take a look at some of the productivity tools found on the productivity tab in the assembly environment. These tools involve different operations that we can use to speed up our process and resolve some issues. One of the tools that that we found pretty useful is rename browser nodes. If we happen to come in here and change the name of an occurrence inside of our browser, and then later decide, you know, I want to replace that that component. So we come in and we use component replace, and we decide we're going to replace it. You'll notice that that browser name did not change after we did the replace. Well, using our rename browser nodes, we can come in and decide I want to change my file name, I want to change my part number, or go back to the default. So selecting file name very quickly fixes that name in the browser, and makes things pretty simple. Another thing we can very quickly do is save and replace component. So If we select save and replace component, select that component, and then come up with a new name. Let's call this one bucket scoop. Now that's completely changed. Once again, we might want to come in and update our browser nodes and apply those. So we can very easily change that, and we can come in and edit or open our existing file, make changes to it without any issues. So a very quick way to save and replace those components. Another tool on our productivity panel is add part or add assembly. This will add an empty part to your assembly for editing or changing later. So it's very simple. We can just very quickly create a part, and we'll save that. It puts a part inside of the assembly that actually has no geometry. So once again, we can come in and take that, edit that out, add in a pin, add in whatever we want to do, however we want to work through that process. Project some geometry. Let's change that visibility. And very easily, very quickly, we can add that in. Now, obviously, that part's not constrained. Nothing too terribly difficult about going through and reconstraining those parts. Just a different method to add in parts allows us to come in and make those changes pretty quickly without too much issue. There are some additional tools on here. We can see working with our substitutes and creating derived substitutes. We can see deriving components and placing a component at the origin. Changing our sort options in our browser. We can do an alpha sort so we can change how those nodes are listed. We can ground and root a given component, and we can look at our degrees of freedom. Test some of these out. There's some neat tools in here. We've got different ways from right click menus and so on and so forth. But with this productivity panel, we seem to be able to move through some of these operations a little bit quicker. Thank you very much.